Hello, boys and girls. It's Becca Switzer with Roof Sales Mastery, author of Diamonds in the Sky. Zane Frings, my left-handed right man, to my left. Cruising through the mountains, I am drinking road wine. And thank you to my hairdresser, Becca Chaffone, who, first of all, deserves all the credit for making my hair awesome and for my lack of sobriety today that I hope to achieve soon at the summer solstice party that I'm on my way to. Anyways, Zane and I were actually just having a discussion, and we always have such great discussions, and during those conversations we're like, man, that'd be a really great podcast, and that'd be a really great video topic, and we're like, well, we got about 45 more minutes before we get to this party, so let's cash in on this conversation.
Let's go.
And what we were talking about was criticism. And nobody likes to hear criticism, obviously, because criticism makes us feel like we're doing something wrong, or we're a fuck up or whatever. But, you know, something that I just had a reflection on is earlier in my life when I was younger, more immature, more insecure, I was not very good at taking criticism. But over the last couple of years, I've really been working on, and I'm actually pretty proud of myself for how I'm able to accept criticism. And the reason that Zane and I were just talking about, the reason that I value those moments is, if somebody gathers the courage, and I'm not talking about random criticism from a stranger on the internet or just some asshole at the grocery store or something like that, but if somebody that plays a valuable role or you have a relationship with in your life offers constructive criticism and calls you out for something that you could do better, you should value those moments. I value those moments that somebody had the balls to come and say, hey, this is something that I feel when you do or say this, and I need those moments, because without those moments of somebody coming forward and shining a spotlight on me, it's like a mirror, right? Other people can reflect as a mirror and go, hey, you know, this is something that you do, and this is how I feel when you say stuff like that, or when you behave this way, or when you react in that manner. Those moments are mirrors for you to see what you're doing so that you can improve. Don't we all want to be the best possible person we can be? Don't we all want to make people feel good? Don't we all want to do the best possible job that we can and create the best results that we can? Because if you do, if you say yes to that statement, you have to humbly accept criticism. As soon as somebody comes to me and says, hey, you know, this is something, you know, offers me criticism of some kind, I have made a real effort to just be quiet and hear them. I'm not gonna try to defend myself. I'm not gonna try to interrupt. I genuinely want to hear what they have to say, especially if it's somebody who I'm in a relationship with, whether that's romantic or platonic or it's a working relationship or whatever, any type of relationship, because what I know as a secure individual is this person is coming to me and sharing this criticism because they care about our relationship. And they care about me as a person, or they care about the result that we are working on as a team. So if they have something to say, I should absolutely not only give them the opportunity to say it, but really take to heart and open my heart and my ears and my mind and hear what they have to say so that I can improve. You should value those moments of opportunity. They are moments of opportunity when somebody offers you criticism. And only insecure people or people who know that they're messing up get defensive and try to split hairs or try to defend themselves or discount what you're saying or gaslight you or whatever. So this is just a message to help you really capitalize on moments where you can have an opportunity to growth, because that is what criticism is. And again, there are discernment. There's just random criticism that's like, that doesn't offer me any feedback and it was just mean. And then there's criticism that comes from people who actually give a shit. You should listen to those people. It will improve your life and it will improve your relationships. As always, subscribe to the YouTube channel. You can check out roofsalesmastery.com for my actual sales training programs. Keep it crunchy out there, you guys. I will chat with you guys on the next one. Bye.